Hello and welcome to the course CS353 Grid Computing. This is the first lecture of module 5. And in this talk, we are going to discuss about grid monitoring. And this is the introduction part of grid monitoring system. We know that a grid environment is potentially a complex globally distributed system that involves large set of diverse geographically distributed components used for a number of applications. The diversity of these components and their large number of users render them vulnerable to faults, failures, and excessive loads. Hence, suitable mechanisms are needed to monitor the components and their use, hopefully detecting conditions that may lead to faults or failures. That's why we need to monitor the entire grid system and provide a technicality or technical capability so that we can make available a robust, reliable, and efficient environment for the user of a grid system. That's why monitoring is needed. With this overall view, let us start. What is the grid monitoring system and how the architecture of a grid monitoring system helps us in accessing the grid systems seamlessly without any failure or problem occurred. So first of all, let us introduce what do you mean by a grid monitoring. So if you observe here, so grid monitoring is particularly known as observing the components of a grid environment and their uses to hopefully detecting conditions that may lead to fault or failure of the system. So the meaning is we have to by any mean, by software or maybe some software components, we need to observe or monitor the components that are present in the grid environment, and we are trying, hopefully we'll get a problem over there, but we are trying to observe it and trying to find out is there any problem occurred in the entire system or not. If the problem occur, then we have to take a measure to solve it. Okay, that is one definition. Another definition, I brought it from a different paper. It is written, the process of measurement and publication of the state of a grid resource at a particular point in time. So at a particular point in time, at a moment, we can publish what is the state of our grid infrastructure or grid system. And if the state is conducive, that means everything is going fine, then our applications can run very easily. If it is not, then what should be the measurement we should take to find out the problem or to solve the problem present in the entire grid system. So that is what grid monitoring is. Building a grid infrastructure and without monitoring it does not solve all the problems. That's why monitoring is always necessary. Now let us see in a simple points why we need grid monitoring. What benefit it gives us to the user. So monitoring a grid is needed to understand performance, identify problems, and to tune a system for better overall performance. So the three points that I have mentioned over here. Understand the performance. So we can analyze the performance of the grid system by monitoring it. We can identify if any problem occur during the execution of the entire grid system or we can tune it for getting a better performance from the entire grid system. So that's why grid monitoring is always needed. We know that grid monitoring system, grid infrastructure or grid environment provides us the fault detection and error mechanism or recovery mechanism. So if we don't have any mechanism to monitor the system, how the fault detection and recovery mechanism will work? So always a fault recovery and detection mechanism needs some monitoring of data inside the grid environment. So second point I have written, fault detection and recovery mechanism need the monitoring data. So what he will do with this monitoring data? To help determine if parts of an environment are not functioning correctly and whether to restart a component or redirect service request elsewhere. That means if particular component is overloaded, we can redirect the next request to other components. We can also find if any problem arises in a particular component, we can change the component or we can modify the works or the assigned work to that component to other components. So fault detection and recovery mechanism always needs this monitoring data. So after you understand what do you mean by grid monitoring system and grid, why a grid monitoring is required, let us understand what are the different components of your grid management system. So basically there are five components in a grid management system. One is called sensor management, information management, data archiving and presentation. So let us discuss one by one. These are so simple components, and every grid environment, whenever a grid monitoring infrastructure has been built up in a grid environment, they need to have all these components integrated together in that system. But still, lots of systems which are exist in the market today don't have all these components integrated together. Okay, but grid system demands or grid monitoring system demands all these features to be integrated in the entire environment. So what do you mean by a sensor now? A sensor is a process that performs actual monitoring of resources. Data that sensor generates is called an event. Okay, so sensor is something which performs actual monitoring of the resources. So you can think it as a software who monitors a particular device in the grid computing environment and sends the data or stores the data, and that data which is generated by the sensor is actually called an event. The next component is your sensor management that allow user to remotely configure and control the sensor. So this management means any software that allow us to remotely control the sensor is known as your sensor management component. Third component is your information management. Information management component enables sensor to publish events as well as consumers to discover data of interest. Similarly, I mean, another point is information management uses some sort of a database to store information about available sensors and monitoring events. Okay, so these two work has been managed by your information management. So the first work is publish the event as well as discover the data of interest, means something which need to be published, which type of events a consumer want, that need to be published, and consumer must able to discover that event whenever he needs on that. Then fourth point is your data archiving is necessary for post-mortem performance analysis, accounting and resource utilization statistics. So obviously whenever we are monitoring a system, means we should make available the day-to-day performance analysis, or we can store the data in a database so that further processing or historical analysis on the data can be possible. Okay, so that is related to your data archiving. Finally, the presentation means it is a graphical view of the monitored data. So that means there must be some component which enable us the data analysis and the graphical view of monitored data, right? So these are the five components that are associated with your grid monitoring system. Now the next part we are going to discuss is your grid monitoring architecture. So let us discuss on this. So this grid monitoring architecture is a overall view how the grid monitoring means the grid monitoring is handled in a grid environment. Okay. So this was published by your grid means grid forum, that is grid community forum. Okay. So they have published this paper and give an overall idea of how should be the grid monitoring architecture and what should be the component of a grid monitoring architecture. So those are shown in this particular figure. So where there are three different components must be present in the architecture. One is called consumer, second one is called producer, and third one is your directory services. So quickly I will explain the three component of this architecture, and later on I will go on detail of each component, what is the work of their means, what does they do during the management of the or the monitoring of the system. So that we'll discuss. So a consumer is a service representing the entity. So here the consumer can be anything. It can be a user, it can be a grid subsystem, or it can be an application that demands monitoring of certain resources. So consumer is somebody who try to demand for monitoring a certain resource, means usage of a certain resource. For an example, let's say I want to monitor a CPU, and when the CPU load is more than 50%, then some event may be triggered and showing that your CPU go on, the utilization of the CPU is more than 50%. So that is one type of monitoring of CPU. So any consumer or grid service provider try to know which system or which component of that grid environment has to be monitored. Then the second one is your producer. Producer is service that represents sensor and publishes events. So sensor, as I have already talked about this, sensor is a process that performs actual monitoring of the resources. So sensor generates data. So that will be the producer. The producer is a service that represents a sensor. So generally sensors are represented as producer, and generally they publishes events. Then third point is your directory services. Directory services store information about producers and consumers. So this particular directory service only stores the consumer and producer requirements, or about producer and consumer, how they are related, means for what info, what the consumer is going to consume from a producer. So actually the producer will generate everything, every response to the consumer, but they has to be registered each other in the directory service to show what consumer want and what producer give. Okay, both consumer and producer can register to the directory, as was told to you, that consumer and producer need to register in the directory service. While producer register information about monitored event, consumer can register event of interest. That means the producer will monitor a system, and whatever events occurred in that system will register that value on the directory service. And when consumer register himself over here, he will searches for the registered events which was registered by your producer. Okay, this is how the communication takes place. So there are three type of interaction between consumer and producer. So consumer and producer, both are interacting with themselves for information sharing with three different interactions. One interaction will be publish, subscribe, query response, and notifications. So in publish, subscribe, Consumer subscribes to events of interest and receives data until the subscription is cancelled. Okay. So when consumer want to know or the want to monitor a system, monitor a component in a grid environment, he will register himself on the producer. The producer will the producer will provide all the information about that system for whom, for which the consumer is registered himself. Then on the subscription is over, then the data movement will stop from the producer to consumer. This type of interaction can be initiated by both consumer and producer. So how? If consumer wants some service, he will register themselves in the directory service. And if producer want to say something about a system, then they can register themselves in the directory service. So both way it can be possible. So then next is query and response. In case of query or response, consumer uses information from directory to pull information from producers. So what type of service provided by your producer, consumer may not know. The consumer only know which component he want to monitor. Producer will only know which components he has to monitor and keep the data about. So all the data is present inside the producer. Producer has registered what are the different data available with him in the directory services. Consumer want this, they can query the directory service to find out what are the services available by any producer. So after finding what are the services available, the consumer can directly query to the producer and get the data, right? In final case, producer initiate actions by providing data to the consumer. Okay, so finally producer will send the data which is queried by your consumer. Okay. So let us discuss about the different type of consumer. What are they? So I'll one line for what is a consumer. So consumer is nothing but it is a program that receives monitoring data from a producer. Can be a consumer, means it can be receives a monitoring data event from a producer. Okay. It is possible to have number of different type of consumers. So what are the consumers? One is called archiving consumer. So who are archiving consumers? I'll read all these steps because these are so simple to understand. So I have written everything in the slide itself. So I'll read it and I will try to explain what is the technicality behind all these points. So the archiving consumer aggregates and store monitoring data for later retrieval and or analysis. So generally this type of consumer store the monitor data. He has collected it from producer and store it, and they want that data for historical purpose. Means he may later on analyze those data for any problem occurred or something like that. He will not work on real time basis. Okay. An archive consumer subscribe to producers, receives event data and place it in a long term storage. So after receiving the data from the producer, he will store it in a storage device. Archive consumers may also act as a GMA, that is your grid monitoring architecture producer, to make the data available to other consumer. So later on he will act as a GMA producer, grid monitoring GMA producer means he will be acting as a producer for other consumers. Okay, because all the data has been archiving by this archiving consumer. Second one is your real-time consumer, who will collect monitoring data in real-time, as opposed by your archiving consumer. A real-time consumer potentially subscribes to multiple event of interest and receives one or more streams of event data. Fine. So the third point will be overview consumer. So what are the overview consumers? They collect events from several sources and use the combined information to make some decision that could not be made on the basis of data from only one producers. So that means these type of consumer will access the data from multiple producers. So if this is a consumer, they can access the data from multiple producers. So these are all producers, right? So collect the information from multiple producers and make decisions. Then job monitoring consumer can be used to trigger an action based on an event from a job, like you're restarting a job. So whenever a job is continued, job monitoring consumer can restart a job currently, whatever event is occurring. So he can trigger another event based on the data collected from the producer. Then comes the producer. So producer is nothing but it is a software. A producer is a software component that sends monitoring data. Monitoring data is known as events to a consumer. Producer can deliver events in a stream or in a single response per request. So there are two ways a producer can send the data to the consumer. What happens in streaming mode? In streaming mode, a virtual connection is established between the producer and the consumer, and events can be delivered along this connection until an explicit action is taken to terminate it. So in streaming mode, the consumer will connect to the producer with a virtual line or virtual connection, and the data get transmitted continuously until and unless the termination happens. So termination can be done in both ways. Either the producer will terminate or the consumer will terminate. If they both are in a connection, the data transferring is called as the streaming mode of data transfer. But in a query mode, it will be a request response type of communication. So what will happen? The event is delivered as part of the reply to a consumer initiated query or part of a request in a producer initiated query. So if this is a consumer, then he can query something. Consumer, this is your producer. So he will query something, a query will be sent and a response will be generated. And the connection is, there will be no virtual connection. Establishment will be done over there. Sometimes producer also initiates some query, right? So whenever consumer queries, that is a request, okay? Whenever consumer query, that is a reply, because he has already requested something and a reply came. But whenever producer sends, that is a request to the consumer. Then the last one is your directory services. So what is a directory service? When producer and consumer publish their existence in the directory service, they typically specify the event type they produce or consume. So whenever they register, we know that the producer and the consumer need to register in the directory service, right? So when they register, they have to register in the sense that for which event they are for there here. Means producer, for what event he is registering himself, and consumer, what data he need for that he has to register for themselves. The directory service is not responsible for storage of event data, only information about which event instance can be provided. So actual data is not stored in the directory services. Directory services only register what are the different events available. The actual event is available with the producer itself. So finding out what event available, then the consumer can directly contact the producer to get that data about that event. Okay. So functions of directory services is authorize a search, that is establish the identity by authentication of a consumer that want to undertake the search. So first of all, he will authorize a search by establishing the authentication mechanism. Then authorize a modification. So it will be done by establish a identity of the consumer that wish to modify entities. So whenever a consumer want to modify it, then he has to establish the identity of the consumer. Then what the function is continued. The third one is add. The directory service can add a record about an event, update, change the state of a record in the directory, remove a record from the directory. So add, update, remove, all these are operations performed in the directory services itself. Means about a event. Then search, perform a search for a producer or consumer of a particular type, possibly with fixed value for some of the event elements. Okay, so searching, updating, removal, add, everything can be possible through your directory services. In a grid monitoring system, there can be one central directory service or multiple service managed by a directory service gateway. So there may be multiple directory services may be available. So multiple directory services, there can be multiple producers, okay, there can be multiple producer and that can be multiple consumers too. Okay, so producers can, multiple producer can put their events, data about the event in the directory services. Consumer can contact the directory services, any directory services for the event. And finally, data about the actual event data can be received from the producer itself. Okay, that's all about your architecture of grid monitoring system. That's all. The data which has been represented in this slide are collected from these two references. This is the book, The Grid Core Technology by Maus and Lee Mark Becker. This is chapter 5 I am following. And some and many of the data also been collected from this research paper, CRO Grid Monitoring Architecture. Okay, so you can follow, I will upload this file in your team app. You can download over to over, means you can download the, that from there, and also you can read this book too. That's all. Thank you for listening. Bye bye.